At least 77 people have been killed in the Indian state of Kerala by some of the worst floods in a century. Tens of thousands of people have been forced from their homes and the state's main airport has had to be shut down. The latest from Paul Chaderjian now.
Heavy rain, floods and landslides have destroyed or damaged thousands of homes in Kerala. Disaster officers say some 200 people have died since May because of an unusually severe monsoon season.
When water came in, we ran away with whatever we could grab. The water came very fast. We had to save our lives.
The state is home to 33 million people, and 150,000 of them have been sheltering in relief camps. Tens of thousands more remain stranded because 10,000 kilometers of roads have been destroyed or remain underwater.
In our village, everyone's houses were destroyed. It will be a long time before we can go back. I have no idea how long it's going to take and where I will take my family. It will take a long time to rebuild.
Water levels in the state's 34 dams have reached dangerous highs. State officials are releasing water, sending a heavy flow into rivers. The rain has also crippled water and sewage pumps, leaving millions without drinking water.
Our water treatment plants in different places have been submerged underwater. The motors have been damaged. Our first priority is to get the drinking water out to the people.
The monsoons have also wiped out crops in a state known for its spices and coffee. Kerala is famous for its palm-lined beaches and picturesque tea plantations. It's a popular destination for both domestic and international tourists. Meanwhile, Kerala residents are bracing for more rain in the days ahead. Paul Chaderjian, Al Jazeera.
And we've got more now from Rob McElwee, our resident weather expert at Al Jazeera, explaining what is behind all this extreme rain in Kerala. Have a look.
The flooding in Kerala is reportedly as bad as it has been since 1924. And you can see on the satellite picture, certainly a lot of cloud there. But actually, the whitest cloud at the moment is further north. However, in the last 24 hours, there's been at least 200 millimetres in virtually anywhere you want to measure it. And that's not just up in the mountains. This northern one, Karapur, is down on the coast. So the rain's been falling pretty steadily, pretty heavily. Now, throughout Kerala, if you take the monsoon as a whole, it's been 137% of the expectation so far, over 2 metres. So it's no surprise that there's some flooding here. It's not just the rain, of course. They've had to release water from the dams, as I'm sure you already know. Now, over the next 24 hours, there will be further rain all the way down the Western Ghats, including Kerala, but I suspect the concentration might be taken away from Kerala. Now, there's no particular reason why any monsoon should be wetter in one place than another. This is another case in point. I can't tell you why Kerala is especially wet, but over the next day or so, the wettest weather is going to move up temporarily, follow this circulation, which is going to just hit northeastern Karnataka and move slowly westwards. It won't be dry in Kerala, but I think the rain will ease a little bit.
And don't forget the home of weather at AlJazeera.com. All the weather and climate-related news lives there. There are blogs and opinion pieces there. And your location services will, of course, bring you the weather where you are. 43 degrees today in Doha. Hit the More menu at the top at AlJazeera.com. At the bottom of the menu is weather.